why do you think it is that we've been seeing her as a core now in your pubs? Like, what about her toolkit did they change that makes her more viable?
I don't think
she being played mid, I guess?
Yeah, she was mid, but I don't think they changed her that much. I think it's just that I calibrated way too goddamn low. I lost like 2,000 MMR, man.
Top lane, Ulu will get the kills going for this game by bringing down said Dark Willow, taking it out during the metamorphosis. I mean, that's always very decent. Oh, Terror Blade might be in danger. There's no RP, however, so Ulu is still alive for now. They're looking for the angle to try and at least bring him down. They've already skewered him. Ulu, here comes nothing to say. That they've already committed the Scream in the mid lane and the Sonic Wave, so they might not have the full damage, but with all three of these heroes chasing him down, Ulu will eventually die. My goodness, that took forever. Where was Red Panda this whole time, Lizard? He eventually makes his appearance to the top side of the map. They've got the silence out onto nothing to say, and NTS will end up dying.
It's a nice...
brought back by the flame break.
Yeah, it's a nice counter kill at least. You kill off the Queen of Pain, one hero that doesn't want
not
to be...
not immediately there, it could have been dangerous. Speaking of Red Panda, he might be the one that gets brought down instead. Have level 6 though. So Borrow Time will make it a lot more difficult to get this kill. Dude, you could just TP out right now and try to force them to use the RP. But he doesn't, so he probably is going to end up dead here. And indeed, he will die. Sonic Wave committed by NTS. And at this point in time, given how much work he's been putting in, it must just feel satisfying to kill Red Panda.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It is the Magnus that gets the kill in the end, right? So he's getting closer and closer to the blink. I'm just wondering how much of an impact will the Shiro is actually being pursued by the Batrider. This was my train of thought pretty much as well.
Hmm. Like you want to see him be a secondary scaler as well? We'll talk about it in a second, because we actually have a fight breaking out in the top lane. We have a Doom thrown down onto NTS. He should end up dead here no matter what. At the same time, new caught in by the Batrider. So they bring down both of these cores. They don't manage to salvage the tier 1 tower, but what they get out of it, they'll happily make that exchange. 2 for nothing and lots of additional. P, does it go off? It does, but BKB was already popped by XWY and he missed everybody in anyway. Now they just want to try and flee away from this fight. While you smile, turns around, freezing field, gets lifted out and gets cancelled instantly. This fight's still going though. While you smile, falling very low, a couple of hits, he's silenced up. Can they kill him before the Borrow Time finishes? No, they cannot. He does eventually die though. 1 for 1 exchange, it could go more. XWY, no BKB, so he can't avoid this Bramble Maze. And obviously they can't do anything about the Sonic Wave, so they kill off TK and XWY. The chase from the song, I don't think it catches Shang-Chi. As a result of having taken that fight, they've now given away lots of gold. New finishes Harpoon on this Magnus. Bro, this item with this hero is so good, honestly.
Yep. I was just discussing it with John as well in the previous series. Doom?
Yeah, a little bit of danger here. We'll end up getting a quick kill onto Planets. So there used to be a Dark Willow. Didn't really cost them all that much. I mean, Doom as a spell right now with Octarine Core, it's up so fast. Doesn't really feel like you're using it at all.
It still has, yeah, 145 seconds of a cooldown. But yeah, it's nothing, right?
I mean, once it gets to the level 20 talents, then it really is nothing.
Yeah,
it's just like your permanent uptime, it feels, on the Doom.
Yeah. That's really the big difference maker is a little bit better. Like, CM is also good, but once you get all those items, right? Like, once you have a BKB as well and you're running around ulting, Doom does have a BKB here.
Get killed.
Yeah.
He actually jumps into the fight. He gets RP though. Two heroes caught in for this one. Do they have the damage to get these kills? No, they do not. CM still dies, and you now, he's in danger because Terror Blade has shown up for this fight. Song is going to be popped by Shiro, but the BKB ensures that they still catch and kill the Magnus, and now they're going on to Shiro as well. They really want the Naga Siren. They prevented it TPing out. But they're coming, Lizard. They're not going to let this go for free.
Yeah, but they haven't...
And they might not be fast enough.
Yeah, even if they are, they have no meta now. I'm not sure if this is that simple of a fight for them to take. Dark Willow.
They jump onto Planet, but immediately go into the Shadow Realm. We'll keep her alive for now. Turns around with the Bedlam, but still gets brought down. Shiro, him and the boys eventually take down the Roshan and claim the Aegis. But now, Shiro gets himself doomed. They really want to try and get rid of this Aegis at the earliest chance. But look at the damage output from Queen of Pain. Nothing to say, just stacking up these Shadow Strikes. It's really doing a number one to Asterius. They've now lost Red Panda, and they're trying to TP out with Shang-Chi. Not allowed with the skewer from Niu coming in from downtown. They bring down the Doom. They're going on to TK. TK gets RP'd So he's not allowed to leave either. They've just gotten themselves 3 kills, clean and clear. They still keep the Aegis, they keep Shiro alive. They should do it. Buy Phylactery, bro. Do the right thing.
Does it work actually on right clicks as well?
It counters spell damage all that you get on the Shadow Realm, so it does, yeah. Red Panda getting himself dragged outside the base yet again, but he should be fine. Does have the borrowed time. I say that though, because now he's surrounded by illusions and they do kill him. Jump in though, BKB with the Doom AoE coming in. And this time around, because of the BKB, they can counteract the song. However, Batrider wasn't there. Finally, does find the last two. They're trying to drag back Shiro. Do they have the damage to make this happen? Refresh will be there. They get the secondary last two out. And finally, they kill the Naga Siren. Also able to bring down Why You Smile on the Crystal Maiden. What a time to be alive here, Lizard. The Batrider and the Doom are literally itemizing the same, but without the refreshes that they both, they position quite decently on Aster Ares. Terrorblade is the one that's seen first, but it does have BKB Satanic, so no Dark real Willow, danger though. Of dying very early on. Dark Willow doing some not insignificant damage early on. Okay, Lasso coming in onto the Queen of Pain. NTS, he got Echo Shell, but it's not going to keep him alive. He should still die here. And they use the BKBs this time, Lizard, so they do kill him even through the song, but now they might not have backup on life number two, because Queen of Pain does buy back. She squants this fight at the same time. Red Panda forced upon the borrow time with so much damage coming in from the Dank Willow. Terror Blade is falling very low. Magnus ends up dead, can't get off the RP. And now XWY goes, his BKB is back, looking for more targets. The Sonic Wave pushes back these heroes. The secondary Doom comes in. It's not going to find the Queen of Pain, it only finds the Naga, but it's not going to last forever. And eventually they turn back onto the Doom with Freezing Field and just kill him off. Another buyback came in on LGD as they brought back the Magnus. So far, they've been able to more or less win the fight in the positioning because there's no buyback.
But no, instead they want to go for a high ground push first. Mm. Which is also fine because there's no Doom, no Abaddon for 40 seconds. There's no meta as well, right? So it's on cooldown yet, yeah.
Oh! RP wasn't committed in that fight, Lizard, so they still have it available. They committed onto XWY and bring him down. He has to buy back. He does have it available. TK getting gone on right now with these hits from Planet, and they cancel out the stolen Freezing Field by bringing down the Rubick. Double buybacks come in, but already they've lost the lane of Rax. So this is not a situation they want to be in. And they're going to keep the fight going though by going on to Shiro. They lasso him, they drag him back, but there's no meta, so they don't have the damage to bring down this Naga Siren. The Doom will come in though, and that might give them what they need. Shiro does end up dead. NTS and the crew have already tried to beat a hasty retreat, and they will be able to get out. Unfortunately, the thing is though, this Dark Willow, she's doing it again here, Liz. Just slowly sieging from outside. RP coming in right now, new. But TK comes with the Song of the Siren, and where's the AoE Doom, baby? There it is, 1-2, both of them are caused. NTS does manage to walk out, throwing the Sonic Wave back, but he cannot save the life of New, who buys back almost instantly. TK, wait, what? Another one? How did this happen? Doom goes in right now. They want NTS. They catch him out. He will not have an option to leave here. Lasso thrown in Ancient. Just for good measure. And they do find the kill. At the same time, though, the Ancient being besieged upon by Shiro, who's trying to end the game right now. The Ancient still going to be alive, but the Rax will not be, as they've already taken the Megas. At the same time, XWI comes back into the fray. They want to try and find the Batrider, though. Shiro, he's going in. He wants to end the game. Him and you are just hitting the base. They're hitting the building. They RP Terrorblade to buy some more time. They're and Planet also jumps in to get the damage. And with all the illusions and all the little pieces of damage, they get the dub. GG, well played.
Hero.
No. The only good Void game I saw was from Pakaz. He played it one of the lower bracket games. That being said though, it's also Pakaz and Faceless Void. If Pakaz is playing Faceless Void, he can do what he wants. It's just like one of those hero player matchups. Are you smell? Oh, he's fine, dude. He's not fine. He's not fine.
He's fine.
Dude, you know what I keep forgetting how much movement speed Caudle has. My goodness, this hero is so fast.
Yeah, in the Chronosphere, right? Like, this is one of those games in which he needs to be the one killing targets in the Chronosphere. Yeah. Shiro is getting really damn low top.
Yeah, well, we say low, but this is Medusa.
He's still low.
Means very different things. Finally ends up burning through the mana pool, and they do get the kill. Big, big deal there. Why Smile not nearby enough. He doesn't have Nightmare either, so can't necessarily help with a defensive spell to ensure that Medusa lives.
Yeah, sorry, when I said low, I meant low on mana. Thank you. He lost most of it. Imagine if Keeper of the Light had mana leak.
Oh my god, dude, that would be broken. Bottom lane, though, another carry might die here as we go onto the Faceless Void. New with the Trample. Able to bring him down. Red Panda not close by enough to help out in that situation. You know what? They changed the calculation of how damage is calculated? So with like barriers and stuff. So the barrier comes first before anything. And we saw that actually come in clutch and keep the Ember alive. They're coming for him again though. Blood Grenade thrown in by YU Smile. Where are reinforcements? The reinforcements have arrived. It's Red Panda.
Oh no, again.
Shield with the Aquatic Shield. They get the damage out. The damage onto Planet's gonna kill him again. NTS also might actually end up dying. He went back for a swashbuckle, but now he's gonna be silenced. Dead, brought down by the Slider Fist. And that gives XWY level 6. They wanted to kill him before he got 6. Instead, their efforts give him 6, so he can just go home, get nothing as a support it feels anymore.
But this is what you get as a support, right? Like, you get the gratitude of creating space, maybe even killing him here. Like, he was trying. He definitely tried. He used the wand. Like, he had the blood grenade as well. He was like, do I top popped all of this? Abaddon?
Abba gets brought down in this bottom lane. Ulu, still level 5 right now, so no way to really fight back in this area. And scary enough, they're about to have level smoke up and head top. NTS will break the smoke though, scouting out Red Panda. They don't want him though. They were kind of looking for Shiro. And they've stalled him up with the Solar Bind. What more can they get from this? And now here's the reveal of Scarath Mage. They go into the Rolling Thunder as well. NTS able to connect on the two. The Mystic Flare gets dropped down. Between that and some right clicks, TK will end up falling. NTS cleans up Red Panda as well near the secret shop. You do see XWY realize that this is not a fight I want to be involved in, but he remnants it to the wrong place here, Liz. He might end up dead. Why would you do that, XWY? Oh, God.
Bandits.
He gets punished super hard, and he gets tipped. Pain and suffering.
Of course you tip him after he dominates you in the laning stage, and it doesn't matter as long as you silence them. That's his. That's literally his job.
You are the silent spot. And unfortunately, they keep getting lucky enough to kill Red Panda at the beginning of these engagements. So then there's no more aquatic shields, no defense to be mounted. And speaking of Red Panda, he is just dead. The first Fiend's Grip of the game. Mm-hmm. They do kill him, but here's a 4-hero smoke going into the top lane. They want Shiro. Looks like they're all going to find him. The question is, can they kill him? Solar Bind goes in. XWY is on top of him.
That's
Shiro
old.
Losing mana, getting closer and closer. We'll pop the magic wand. Still freaking alive. But eventually we'll have to take a tumble. The question is, can they get out? RP now, committed by Shang-Chi onto this Pango, and there's gonna be a Chronosphere as well, stopping him from just rolling out. That was a very smart move, but unfortunately, Lizard, there's just no damage sitting on this Faceless Void right now, so he just has to get out. New, coming into the fight, Ancient Seal Silence onto Ember Spirit, XWY dead again.
Nothing
Shang-Chi, him and Ulu, just trying to escape this fight. NTS, very low on the HP, would like to chase a little bit further.
Makes sense versus the Doza, right? Like you also do have the Empower to work with, so.
Top lane. They're trying to bring down Magnus here. Neo coming in onto the other side. Rolling Thunder connects. Mystic Flare will be there and he will eventually die. Red Panda tried his best, but there's a limit to what you can do, my friend. Gets pulverized for his efforts as well, so might also not be allowed to escape this one. And indeed, as the borrow time elapses, so does his life. Taken down in front of the tier 2 tower. And Bane gets a double kill off the back of this. Wow. Alrighty.
Everything. Can they use it though? That's the question. Like they
what
have
kind
no
of vision
chrono.
Do they have? Yeah, there's no chrono. There is going to be a jump in. New looking for a target. Can't find anybody just yet. Why you smile? There's an RP on the two. Can they finish this off though? Pulverize. Wait till onto Ember Spirit so there's no follow-up damage. Mystic Flake is dropped as well by the Skywrath Mage. So they will be able to eliminate Faceless Void. Magnus got a 3-hero skewer, but it's not going to help him as he dies as well. NTS rolling through to Ember Spirit, enabling the Shiro damage to rain in onto XWI and kill him off. Thing is happening. They might not know the angle. Let's follow Shang-Chi on the right-hand side. He's the important one. He has the RP, but there's no viable targets for him, Liz. So just forced to watch Medusa plinking down their buildings. They do finally find a skewer back. Nice little nightmare. While you smile, saves himself and keeps his life going a little bit longer. Will eventually die, but it might end up being exchanged for XWY. A nice little chrono onto two core heroes, but he's disarmed. He can't get any damage into the bubble. RP will eventually come. It only hits onto the Primal Beast, however, and they still don't have the damage. They can't kill anybody. Shockwave will eventually finish off Neo. But my goodness, LGD. Just so much more durable than Chain Disable. The Rock Throw took a little bit too long from Nyu. Can't chain him. But at the same time, Shiro, oh, gets Chrono'd, but they do manage to dodge it as NTS. So unfortunately, this Chronosphere does literally nothing. So Shiro's like, well, you've dropped Chrono? Sweet, I'm just gonna go back to hitting the buildings. Nyu, try to jump in. Not gonna be able to find the RP though.
That really hurricane
pike from Shiro was super sick. And now it's Blink Dagger gone now for another 5 seconds at least. They're taking down the racks. Oh no, XWY gets jumped on with the pulverize. Can he get out of here? No, he cannot. Dead does have buyback, however. Shiro will pop this stone gaze. It doesn't matter, buybacks or not. They recognize on Ask the Aries that they have nothing left to give. So it turns out, Lizard, that when you have the option and you don't pick the...